Watch out, Nashville. There's a new chef in town.
We're big fans. We got Kristin Beringson here. She is taking over Ellington's Midway Bar and Grill, which is right in the Fairlane Hotel. Very cool. We're getting a taste of your new menu. This has got to be something you've really been working on.
Yeah.
To a chef, the menu is like, it's like a little view into your soul.
Yes.
Little glimpse. No, I've been there for about 3 months now, so this is a big deal. Finally getting my menu out there has been a big project for me, and I'm really proud of it.
Oh, so. We're so glad. Okay, what are some things that people should dive into?
You know, I tried to do, you know, when you go into Ellington's, it's very, like, sexy and modern and, like, mid-century modern. So I tried to do, like, throwbacks to old dishes, like lobster thermidor, oysters Rockefeller.
Oh, fun.
Being from Maryland, I did a little crab cake, which we're going to do here today. Lobster bisque, those kinds of things.
Okay, so you're doing crab cake.
Yep.
Now, is this going to be an appetizer, or is this a dinner menu?
Appetizer.
Perfect.
And you brought a lovely drink. I don't want to ignore the elephant in the room.
Our cucumber basil gimlet. That's on our happy hour menu. We also did just get Best Happy Hour by the Nashville Scene.
So, oh, fantastic.
So our happy hour is a big, big fun time. So
I like a big fun time.
A big fun time. That's going to be my new catchphrase. Okay, let's get started on these crab cakes.
That is a big fun time.
The crab cake recipe you guys will have online. All of these things I've prepared, we're going to do a pound of crab. We're going to mix everything in this bowl if you will assist. Okay.
This looks amazing.
So we've got our lump crab. Actually,
beautiful.
I'm using claw here. You can use lump or claw, whatever the grocery store has. We're going to do some panko breadcrumbs, which are just Japanese-style breadcrumbs.
Now, did those have any flavoring in them or just plain?
Just straight plain breadcrumbs.
Okay.
All the flavoring's in here. I do a little dry mustard powder, red pepper flake, and Old Bay.
Okay.
Anybody from Maryland knows
Old Bay is
key to our happiness.
There you go.
You dry mustard clumps just like mine at home.
Yep. It's totally normal.
Why is dry mustard always so clumpy? Okay, so
in here we've got parsley and chopped green onions.
Okay. And then do you want the mayo?
Yep, please.
Right.
And
all
I brought
of it?
A little yes, ma'am.
Okay.
I brought a little parsley just so you little tutorial.
Okay.
Make sure you don't use the stems, just use the little leaves.
Really?
Little chef's hack.
Okay.
How many times have I thought I had cilantro and it was not.
The those Italian leaves parsley. Sometimes enter
okay,
in
they
my
do.
World.
I will skip ahead while you're mixing.
Mixing that all up. Now, once you get that all up, are you going to roll it again in the panko?
Yeah, do you want me to glove up a little
glove
bit?
Glove up.
Glove it.
I can glove up.
I brought
do
you
it,
gloves.
Do it.
They're nice and blue. They match your dress just a little
bit. Okay, can I just tell you, I love crab cakes. I think about making them, and then I just get scared. I don't know why.
They're so easy, and
I
you know, when
do.
You put that Old Bay in there, you don't even need any additional salt. Like,
really?
The Old Bay is seasoned, so it kind of takes the guesswork out of, you know, the seasoning part.
Okay.
And kind of adds the flavor.
And it's really the flavor everybody wants.
And over here,
I'm
going to have you mix. I do a little bit of beet relish on my beets.
Like that.
Give it like that sweet earthiness, and then the relish just kind of adds, you know, that acidity. So if you'll mix those two together, you can do this with anything. You can make a relish out of anything, and I like beets. That's just dill pickles, and who doesn't love dill pickles?
I love dill
How
pickles.
How big do you like your crab cake to be?
However you would like it to be, it's up to you.
She's being nice.
And then, she need this?
Yep.
It's a little, do I need that? Oh,
yep.
That's what I
yep,
need
that's
to do.
Yep, that's the key.
Yep.
I was like, I feel like there's something.
Got it, dug it again.
And then you can just pop it in the hot oil. You want your oil
to
sit like medium.
Do I just lightly put the panko on?
You can give it a good squeeze, like a little ball it up action.
Yeah, make sure it's in there.
We're going to have a big crab cake. This is a crab burger. We're
burgering
today.
Ooh. I'll balance that up with a small one.
I'm gonna sit this right to you.
Yeah.
Right.
I feel like I need to redeem myself.
I want to make sure
we're
not gonna have to cook until Wednesday because I made it so big.
Really, you're just cooking it until it's golden brown. Like
the
crab is already cooked through. We didn't use any eggs here. The mayonnaise is binding it. So you really just are going for the golden brown and delicious thing.
Oh my gosh, that makes me even less scared because you're right, the crab is already cooked.
Everything's good to go. You're just making it crispy and tasty.
Beautiful.
And this is our end product. I serve it with a little bit of malt vinegar remoulade on the plate. You could use tartar sauce. You can use whatever you like with crab cakes. I like a little bit of malt vinegar remoulade. And the relish on top and my cute little chefy greens on top.
Look at our chef.
Kelly.
Guys.
Hold
on.
I'm loving it.
I'm sorry, but when a wonderful chef
and I
comes
can't
in,
forget the...
I'm going to switch and
that.
I'm going to go this.
There you go, guys. This recipe today on... todayinnashville.com. You can go see it there.